Welcome to the parish community of St. Francis of Assisi. In the presence of the resurrected Christ, let us praise God, singing hymn number 302 in the Breaking Bread hymnal. Gather us in, number 302.
The Son and the Holy Spirit. And the Lord be with you. We pause in the presence of our Lord and one another, call to mind our sins, and ask God's forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you came to announce the good news of salvation to the poor and suffering. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners to bring us forgiveness. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you came to bring us new and everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. May our loving God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And now let us praise God in song. Let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for gathering us here today to celebrate our faith in this Eucharist. May we become aware of your presence, not only in your word of scripture, but in the breaking of bread and in the community. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Seek the Lord, all you humble of the earth, who have observed his law. Seek justice, seek humility. Perhaps you may be sheltered on the day of the Lord's anger, but I will leave you as a remnant in your midst, a people humble and lowly, who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm response is on page number 62.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your own calling, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. Rather, God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak of the world to shame the strong. And God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who are something, so that no human being might boast before God. It is due to him that you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, as well as righteousness, sanctification, and redemption, so that, as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Jesus began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. And blessed are the clean of heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers. They will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. It's good to be back. I always had a problem with the Beatitudes. How could somebody be blessed when they're poor? Sometimes in certain translations, instead of saying blessed, they say happy. How can you be happy when you're poor? Everybody should have food, clothing, and shelter, and justice in their lives. What does it mean to be poor in today's gospel? And why does Jesus bless the poor? I think we have to look at the word poor in a very different way than perhaps we're used to. You know, you say you're in poor health, you don't have any money, so you're poor. There was an example, I think, that brings this out, what Jesus is talking about. Back in, I think it was 83, I used to cover about 10 different chapels, parishes in South America. And after Mass, the people would oftentimes take me to their home for breakfast. So on this one occasion that I'll never forget, a couple invited me, a family invited me to their house for breakfast. So I went and I sat down and they were around the table and they had homemade bread and et cetera, et cetera. And after about 10, 15 minutes after our conversation, the woman, the wife, brings out a plate of eggs for me, two or three eggs, I forget, and puts it in front of me. So I was thinking to myself, I'll wait, because I don't want to, you know, start eating. It's impolite to start eating. And so as time went on and my eggs were getting cold, the woman says to me, go ahead, Father, eat. I says, no, it's okay, I'll wait for the rest of you. She says, Father, these are the last three eggs we have. Can you imagine how I felt? If you didn't eat, that's not good. You wouldn't respect the people. If you ate, you'd feel like this. Poverty means letting go of what you have in order to fill yourself up with something different. They let go of the food that they had in order to bring in a stranger, me, to welcome a stranger at their table. That's being poor. That's what Jesus is talking about in today's gospel message. That's why the poor are blessed, because they forget about themselves and look out after the other. They forget about themselves and open up their hearts to the presence of God. I call it baggage. You and I carry a lot of baggage with us. Huh? We don't want to let go of that baggage oftentimes. Baggage. We think all the time, oh, what am I going to wear? What am I going to eat? What about this person that I don't like? And we don't leave room for God. We don't let go so that God could come in. And I think throughout the Beatitudes, this is very, very important. Not to carry excess negative or any negative baggage in our hearts or in our lives, so that we can make room for the presence of God in our lives and to become aware of that. That's what the kingdom of heaven means. I think it's Luke that uses kingdom of God. And what Jesus is saying, and we have to kind of take it to heart, is no matter what you're going through, no matter what struggles you're going through, that God is still with you. You might not succeed in being a peacemaker, or you might not succeed in being meek even though you try hard. It doesn't matter to God. That God is always with you through thick and thin, and that the more that you and I can let go of those negative thoughts, those negative feelings concerning either ourselves or other people or society or governments, the more we let the presence of God into our life. And the more we do that, the more we change our lives, because the presence of God could push us in different directions. Not to be discouraged, in other words. Yeah? Failure. We say, oh, I don't want to fail. Well, maybe we learn something when we fail. When we fail, I think we have to look toward, we have to look for the presence of God in our life. Baggage. Many people who are poor, because they are poor, are able to give what they have to others in order to receive from the Lord God's presence. And I think this is what is really important in today's gospel message. How well can we get rid of negativity in our lives? How well can we let go of the hatred that we feel toward people? The more we can do this, let go, and remembering God's presence within us, the more we grow in our faith, and the more we develop ourselves as human beings. So, give your eggs away, huh? Let go of those things. Even though you don't have, you let go like those that family did in South America. And they let go to welcome in the stranger. If they were filled with themselves, I got to eat, I got to eat, I got to eat, there was no room for anything else. God needs room in our hearts and in our lives in order to grow in the faith. That's why we need one another. We have to depend on one another. So we're not overwhelmed by discouragement and hardship and failure and lack of resources, even though they're important. Oftentimes, God is still with us through thick and thin. So I have a little bit more of an understanding of what it means to be blessed when you're poor, but I still can't live it at this point because it's very, very difficult to let go. Very, very difficult to look at life in a different way. Jesus always had a soft spot, so to speak, for the poor and those who are struggling. And what he was saying, he says to us, I'm always with you. I don't want you to suffer, but if you are, I'm there. Can that give you strength? I hope so, because our lives are not perfect. We struggle each and every day. But remembering and experience the presence of God in our lives and in our hearts will give us the strength that we need. And then God will say to us, blessed are you. The kingdom of heaven is yours. Please stand and let us profess our faith in our God. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Christ, his only Son, our Lord, born of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, on the third day he rose again, ascended to heaven. Seated at the right hand of the Father, Almighty, where he should come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Holy Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. And now let us place our needs, our petitions before the Lord.
For unity among Christians, let us pray to the Lord. For the strength needed for members of the church to seek out blessedness of the kingdom of God, by walking with the poor and the abandoned. Let us pray to the Lord. For perseverance for the people of Ukraine and all who are experiencing violence and war, let us pray to the Lord. For solace and healing for the families and communities suffering from the California mass shootings, let us pray to the Lord. For a national conversion of heart in regard to common sense gun control and the care of people suffering from mental illness, let us pray to the Lord. For a sense of purpose for people working toward justice for the least within our society, let us pray to the Lord. For a deepened relationship with Jesus for parents, the first teachers of our children, in discovering the presence of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the gift of humility and a poverty of spirit within each of us, that we may only boast in the Lord Jesus working in our lives, let us pray to the Lord. For the gift of hope in people who are wandering and seeking the presence of God in their lives, let us pray to the Lord. For healing and comfort for the sick, infirm, and dying in our community, let us pray to the Lord. For hope for all who mourn and eternal life for our dead in Christ, including Bishop Matthew Clark of Rochester, Robert J. and Robert M. Keegan, Robert and Karen Catherine Frank, Dominic F. and Anna T. Allegretta, Frederick Bernacki, Cheryl Bernacki, Aurelio and Teresa Giglio, Lucy and Paul Tudico, and Jacqueline Smith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For the people and situations we hold deep within our hearts and bring to this holy table, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, with confidence and trust, we have placed our needs before you, and we ask you, if it is your will, to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we prepare the Lord's table and ourselves to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, let us join in singing hymn number 387 in Breaking Bread, The Summons, number 387.
Let us pray together that our offerings may be acceptable to our loving God. Generous God, we offer you these gifts of bread and wine. May they lead us through death to new life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we proclaim your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, after the supper, he took the chalice, once again gave you thanks and praise, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And now in song, let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all your people. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her husband Joseph, with the apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now let us pray together in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on
earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
Amen.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, Body of Christ, Regina. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, Ralph. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, Father. Body of Christ, Father. And let us pray. Lord, may your word and your sacrament continue to nourish us throughout the week. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. May our loving God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And let us go now in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another. Thank you.
I have an announcement before we close. Next Sunday is Hospitality Sunday. So after the 10:30 Mass, please, there will be a listserv announcement for those of you who are not online. I'm saying it now. Please be generous with your fruits, vegetables, baked goods. We will meet across the street after the 10:30 Mass. Thank you very much. The usual coffee, tea, and juice will be offered. Thank you.
And let us go forth singing hymn number 499 in the Breaking Bread hymnal, Go Make a Difference, number 499. Oh, wait. Okay.
Jackie got it.